Secretary, I wanted to ask, what are your thoughts on the feasibility of net zero or zero carbon emissions by 2050? Is that realistic without offsets? So not carbon neutral, but zero carbon.
I believe that we can get there.
Yeah.
We need to approach this with a sense of urgency. And the plan that I've put out pursues this with a tremendous sense of urgency. In order to accomplish that, it's going to take leadership here at home, it's going to take investment of resources here at home, and also across the public sector at every level, federal, state, local, and also the private sector and nonprofit sector, that same sense of urgency and of investment.
And can I ask, your PAW plan about biodiversity and animal welfare, what personally compelled you to create that plan? Because I think you're the only candidate that's addressed animals, biodiversity, how we treat animals, and that's really special, you know, for all of us. We saw that plan come out and we're like, yes.
We had a lot of fun with that. Candidly, we've done a lot of policy, but this was the one policy that protecting animals and wildlife that I was excited, and a lot of people on the campaign, you know, didn't quite recognize, oh, why would a presidential candidate put out this plan about animals and wildlife? But when I was mayor of San Antonio, one of the priorities I had was getting San Antonio to no-kill status at our shelters, because we used to euthanize about as many cats and dogs as Los Angeles, even though San Antonio was a lot smaller than LA.
Yeah.
So I saw that we could make progress in treating animals better. And I do think that the way that we treat animals says something about us as people.
Are you an animal lover? Is that how that plan came to be?
Growing up, my grandmother probably had like 11 different cats.
Wow.
My brother and I had dogs. I don't have a pet right now, but we're looking at getting a dog because my kids are of the age now where they could have a dog.
Yeah. And one more question for you. If you were to pick any of your competitors to serve in your cabinet, which ones would you pick? Would you offer Governor Jay Inslee a position?
I would love to see him as the head of the EPA. In fact, our climate action plan was basically based off of the blueprint that he set out in his campaign, and my campaign worked with his former campaign advisors. They touched base with them, and so we've constructed it based on the blueprint that he set out. But, you know, we have a lot of people who are super talented.
Mm-hmm.
That's the great thing about this race, is that we know that any one of the folks running would be a lot better than Donald Trump, and better in many ways, including for our environment.
Mm-hmm.
And if I were the nominee and became president, then I would be very happy if many of the people who are running would agree to serve in my administration.
Great. Could you get just a couple rapid-fire fun ones? So, veggie burger or impossible burger?
Veggie burger.
Bike or scooter?
Oh, bike. If you're talking about those scooters that are all over the cities right now, I would just rather do it the old-fashioned way. It's a bike,
Turn off the lights or energy-efficient light bulbs?
Energy-efficient light bulbs,
And then the last one is record player or Spotify?
Spotify.
Okay. Well, that's all we have for you. Thank you.